Hello, my name is Dr. Colin Campbell. I'm a senior research scientist here at Meter Group, and today we're just going to give a brief primer on thermal time. When I talked to some of my colleagues about that, they mentioned that this is really just a way to match a plant clock or a plant's clock with our clock. So we understand what's happening with the plant and can predict things like emergence, like maturity, etc. And the way we do this is through this equation here. That's actually, when we look at it, pretty simple. It just says that we can sum thermal time by taking this summation of day one to day n of the average temperature, meaning T max plus T min divided by two, minus a base temperature, and then multiply by a time step. And in this case, our time step is just one day. So basically, the whole analysis is simply average temperature minus a base temperature. We get that value each day, and we keep summing until it reaches a value that tells us that we've progressed from one stage to another stage. A good example of this is just wheat. And when I was young, I actually did an experiment on this in biology, and I was super amazed to see that it actually worked. That this idea is that for emergence, the wheat plant needs 78 day degrees to actually step through from planting to emergence. And so I just used this equation here, and when I had summed enough of these day degrees, I knew it was stepping from that planting stage to a post-emergent stage. And I went and measured it, and it actually matched up really well. Not every wheat plant emerged at that point, but the average actually was quite close. So what does that mean in terms of graphical data? So I just wanted to show you what this equation actually did, and then plant a little seed in your mind for our next discussion, which is, how good is this analysis? Because if you think about it, with modern technology like Meter Group's ATMOS 41, we can get temperature measurements that are every 5 minutes or every 1 minute. So wouldn't it possibly be better if we collected our thermal time information by taking the sum over each day, like we did in the other equation, but instead taking the integral of temperature at a small time step, like 5 minutes, minus the base temperature, and then just integrating this across the day? So we're gonna learn about that in another talk, but here let's go to this graph. We have temperature on the y-axis and time on the x-axis. The total time here, of course, is just 24 hours. So this is our daily step where we're collecting this information about thermal time. And here are all these parameters from the equation. So here's the maximum temperature, here's the minimum temperature, this one here is the average temperature, and then this is a base temperature. And I just want to say, just to familiarize you with what we're talking about, this is the temperature below which that progress is not made in the development of this plant. It's not like we reverse the progress, so if it's below the base temperature, it's not backing up on its development, but it just doesn't progress. Now, this black line here is just what I've drawn of a typical diurnal temperature swing. So it's going from a minimum, of course, in the early morning up to a maximum sometime in the afternoon. And what I've done is try to compare these two approaches. So on this side, we have the average temperature, we have the base temperature, and so all of this in this rectangle here, that is our thermal time for that day. But the question is, if with all our data, like from the ATMOS 41, where we have pretty small time increments, could we instead just integrate over the day and then collect all the information on that thermal time here that's below this black line, the actual temperature, and of course we subtract out the base temperature. So is this integral here, how much difference does that make compared to this here? And what is the implications of maybe not being able to measure our temperature terribly accurately? So we're going to talk about that in our next discussion, and I look forward to seeing you then.